So while we were sleeping last night after partying, about 20-something individuals, creative and talented, were here in the back working away, staying awake with those good power drinks and lots of pizza, and basically creating the future that we're talking about, which is why we love talented people who can stay up late at night. So that's why we're setting up here, is to get ready for the big reveal, as they say in reality television. And so we're gonna hear from the hackers, we're gonna hear from the judges, the organizer of the program, and I am waiting for the signal that we're good. So let me invite up the crew. Eric Wu is the first, perhaps, to come up. Oh, Jessie is the first. Good. She's introducing the crew.
That's me. Hi, everybody. Yeah, just super quickly, we had a really exciting night of all-night caffeine. Those hackers arrived, coders, some people call this a codathon, by the way, arrived last night at 6 p.m. and they finished around 6:30 a.m. today. They pitched to five judges this morning from 6:30 to 7:45, 8 a.m. You may have seen them if you arrived early on the scene today. And we had five judges, Aidoo from Qualcomm, you'll hear from at the end. We had Chris Thomas from Fontinalis, Chuck Gulash from Toyota, Sean O'Sullivan from SOSVentures, and Carma, who you'll hear from tomorrow, and Marlin Page from Sisters Code. They were our judges, so let's give them a round of applause for getting up early. Thanks so much, you guys. So our challenge to the hackers were create apps, either mobile or desktop apps, that improve the livability of cities. We kept it very broad, hoping they would come up with the most creative, interdisciplinary stuff. I think you'll be pleased to hear what they came up with. So we have three teams. First app is called Walkable by Olivia Walch. Second is Ourselves by Michael Evans. And the third is called Come Together by Macklin Underdown, awesome name, Jeff Sibbold, and Bryan Kelley. So without further ado, we'll have Olivia up here. Olivia, thanks so much.
All right, I guess we're up first. As Jesse said, we were tasked with creating an app, or not necessarily an app, but an idea that would kind of help the city in many ways. We got a bunch of categories and stuff. So we kind of sat down and said, what bothers us? Macklin here lives in Detroit. Jeff and I work in Detroit along with Macklin. And what we kind of thought is there's a lot of problems and things that could get fixed around the city. And why not have the community kind of come together and basically work on it together, and while you're at it, you know, get to know your neighbors and all that jazz. So we came up with the idea of Come Together is the name of the app. And basically what it is, hang on a sec. We're gonna log in. It's an app that allows the community to kind of get together and plan to work together on a problem that is around them, that's part of their community. Because we figured who's gonna care most about their community and who's gonna wanna help out and basically do work for free. It's hard to get people to do that, but if you live in the area and you care about the area, I'm sure that that's gonna work out. But it's kind of hard to get together and make sure that everybody's on the same page. It's kind of hard for one person to make a difference. So the idea we came up with was basically an app that brings everybody together and helps them plan things. So for instance, you can see on this screen, this is a problem that somebody has posted online. And with that, they can also schedule events. So let's see, this is some blade on the corner. So there's an event scheduled for October 1st. We're gonna clean up the trash together as a community. It kind of gives you the location, gives you the date and the time. You can put a comment like, I'll bring the pizza. Oh, it didn't pan out, but. So that'll actually get posted to the server and kind of help. Yeah, I'll bring, so that didn't quite work out, but let's see, we've got some other ones in here, but. What it does is it uses your current location, so you can kind of see problem areas around you, as well as, let's say, you just want to see what's closest to you, we created a separate view that'll organize the problems by distance according to your current location. Let's see, so this one's kind of cool. We were thinking Macklin actually worked on painting a mural in one of the underpasses around the area, so we thought to put this in there. But let's say, you know, creativity's welcome, and there's kind of a back and forth. So you can kind of plan what the event's gonna be, anything you might need to bring, so if it's landscaping, you know, lawnmowers, stuff like that. But basically the idea is everybody's, like, everybody wants to help out their own community, and it's kind of hard to organize events like this. So we wanted to create an app that would help beautify Detroit and do it in a kind of a fun way and bring, I guess, bring the community together, like I said, get to know your neighbors. That's about it.
Hey everybody, I'm Mike from Loveland, and hopefully you guys look great, so if this works, we'll get a picture of you. So the app that we worked on is actually a riff on a project we did early in this year, where we mapped every single parcel in the city. And we were thinking along the lines of a lot of people that it's really great for giving people the ability to work inside of their own communities. So what we did is we created an app where there's a pool of money that can be raised by foundations, municipalities, even people in the neighborhood, and then they can post the things that they need done, and anybody is able to come in and pick up those bounties to get the work done. So as an example, the first thing we would do is we have two options, report and fix. So I go ahead and say, I would like to fix something. And also, all of our stuff is based off the parcel. Because if you want to deal with municipalities and have stuff taken care of, you need to have something beyond just using an address. So this includes, you know, water liens, property taxes, that sort of thing. We can connect all this together. So I'm going to tap this parcel and hit report. And we have here a list of possible things that you can go ahead and say needs fixing. So overgrown lot, there's a lot of those in Detroit that need to be mowed. The city doesn't have the greatest amount of resources to do that. So we'll go ahead and take a picture of everybody. Smile. All right. And we will submit that. And it's just that easy. So it says, hey, thanks for the report. If you have, you know, a pool of money in your neighborhood, there will be an automatic bounty set to it that then people can collect. If not, people can still do it out of the goodness of their hearts. So they can report another one or add more money to the pool. So now I'm going to exit out of here and jump back in as someone who wants to fix something. How's my time? Okay. And 1 second. All right, so we're logged in now, and I'm gonna go ahead and say I need to fix something. So we have a list of other things that we've done for testing over the past 12 hours, and here's you guys. So you're overgrown, the bounty on this is $20. So I'm a kid or somebody who has access to a lawnmower through a community group or something like that, and I could use $20. I'll come in here, take a look at it, shows me where it is, shows me the picture that was taken, shows me the address, the bounty that's on it. Here we have information, so if this is going into production, right, we want to give these people advice on how to take care of this, right? We don't want them to be unsafe. So I'll say, yeah, I went ahead, I fixed this lot, so I'm going to click report this property and get you guys all cleaned up and submit that. And it just comes back and says, hey, you're awesome. You helped fix a problem. If there was a bounty on this, you can, after the person who submitted it gives you a thumbs up that you did it, you'll be debited, you know, the cash to your account. And you helped fix something. And then also here, we can see these come in live as well. So here's where I said that you guys were overgrown and needed to be fixed. And here's where we came in and fixed it. And we can see onto the parcel level, you know, the type of information that's connected to that if the thing loads, but we're running out of time. But so yeah, we think this is a solution, well not the only solution, but something that you can use to help out your neighborhood and also put people to work on a temporary basis if people need extra dollars in their pocket. So that's our project, thanks.
All right, so I'm the last one. My name's Olivia. I'm from the University of Michigan, and my app is called Walkable. It's about walkability. I'm guessing I don't need to convince this crowd that walkability is a thing and a good one. It promotes the physical health of city dwellers. It improves public space. You get out and get to breathe some air. And so it's a good thing, but how can an app help make it more practical? And I think my answer to that was user-generated content. And so I turned to websites and apps like Pinterest and Polyvore. You guys probably spend less of your free time on these websites than I do. That's okay. I spend a lot of time on there, and it's driven by user content. And it's a very like design focus kind of approach to getting people to create content. And that's what I wanted to do with Walkable. So what you do is you log and share walks. You can add points of interest along the walks and give your walk a theme. So maybe you're really into the street art of your neighborhoods. You can have a street art themed walk. Maybe, like me, you just want some coffee and you can have a walk that highlights your favorite coffee shops. Because I have terrible shaky hands, we have a video here. It's also on my phone. Oh no, okay, we're gonna fix this. Instant fix, piece of cake. One more time. All right, so here's a list of walks I logged. They could come from any user. I logged in for this through my Facebook account, but since it's through a framework called Parse, you could do Facebook or through email. I'm giving the walk a name. I'm adding a description. These places rule. And I'm giving some tags. And then I'm gonna go record my walk. And so right now, because I was in this building all night, the walks you just draw by hand. So I'm gonna draw a walk. The little plus sign is us right now. I'm holding each point to add a new point. And then I'm gonna click add point of interest. You might recognize the point of interest. It's him. And so that's saved as one of the points of interest on my walk, Mike. And so then I can review this, and to make it look more appealing, I've added some triangulations. It's now like this cool shape. It's a way of visualizing my walk, and I can see all the other walks in my neighborhood, and I can click on them if I want and rate them. And so on this page, there's also this view. This is a shot of one of those walks with the triangulation on it, and I've put a collage of sample pictures that could have come from a walk like this. Unfortunately, I only had pictures of Mike, and I swapped them out for ones from the internet, but it's this idea of making an attractive art piece to motivate people to generate content, to motivate them to generate walks that new people to the city can find, try, and engage with. So thank you very much. That's my hack.
Thanks, you guys. You can stay up here for a second. I just wanted to click through some photos from last night so you guys can see them all at work on their caffeine highs. And so this was a competition. We had more teams than these three. These are our top three teams that got through to the plenary round so they could present in front of you today. And we're going to have Aidoo from Qualcomm, who, thank you, Qualcomm, for sponsoring this hackathon. And Aidoo from Qualcomm is going to announce the winner and also some kudos for others. Aidoo.
Absolutely. As you guys know, I think civic hacking is an important way to get citizens involved in the process of making cities better. It drives open data sets, and it also drives engagement for all different demographics. So I think these types of innovators are to be commended. So how about a round of applause for all of our contestants? Massive amounts of pizza and caffeine were consumed here, and they were actually locked in to this entire floor for an entire night. So thanks for not throwing a big, massive party. I also want to thank the other judges. So we had Marilyn Page. You want to just stand up. Chuck Gulash, Sean O'Sullivan, and Chris Thomas. And we had heated debates. It was not an easy decision to determine which one of these fine contestants should win. But after we looked at technical complexity, business viability, originality, we came up with Michael Evans, ourself, as the winner.
Congratulations. Thank you.
And as a University of Michigan grad, I was not able to be influenced by the U of M tie. Go Blue. But just thanks again, and once of all, a round of applause for our contestants. Thanks again. Congratulations, Michael.
Good job.